The advantage of EFIS over conventional instrumentation is that you can combine a lot of information on one small area and make it much clearer to read. This is the speed. This is the attitude. This is the altimeter. The green needle here is the vertical speed indicator. 1, 2, 3, 4 instruments combined on one presentation. In addition, we have some compass information at the bottom, and at the top we have the flight mode annunciation, showing at the moment only mark, indicating that the auto throttle is holding us at a speed. The dashes indicate that it's managed nav from the flight management and guidance system, managing the altitude and managing navigation. On the right here, we have information to show that the autopilot 1 is engaged, the flight director 1 is engaged, and the auto throttle is engaged. Let's look at the speed tape for a moment. You can see that the speed is 252 knots indicated. The target speed, the magenta triangle, comes from the FMGS, based on our cost index, our weight, and our height. I can change that to make it selected speed, and it shows blue. In addition, on the speed tape, we have a little trend arrow. You may see it just showing there occasionally, a yellow trend arrow, which gives us our speed in the next 10 seconds. We can also show limitations, and here the red candy stripe marker is the maximum speed. This is showing a speed, indicated speed, equivalent to the mark 0.82, which is our maximum speed at this height. The lower end of the speed scale is showing green dot. First of all, that's our minimum clean speed. There's a little amber line, which you might be able to see, which is the VLS, the minimum selectable speed. And then we're down into the protection area of the angle of attack, alpha prot and alpha max. You can't quite see the stalling speed because it's a little bit below the scale. Now let's have a look at the attitude. This is rather an expanded scale, and it shows the sky, the horizon line, and the ground. The pitch attitude of the aircraft at the moment is 2.5 degrees up. That's fairly normal for a jet aircraft. The green cross is the flight director, and at the moment the selection of the flight director is heading vertical speed. We can change that. If I ask Graham to select flight path and track at the moment, flight path and track, and now we see a different presentation. This is the flight path director showing track, flight path angle. If we turn the flight directors off, we get what is sometimes referred to as the bird, although Airbus in their teaching aeroformation, their training school, are trying to remove that expression, but it's a very good one. There's the bird, and that's showing where the aircraft is going at any time. So if you put the flight directors back on, and Graham will select heading vertical speed, we're back to the green cross. The final presentation on this instrument should be the altimeter shown on the scale on the right. We're cruising at a cleared level of 370, but the autopilot's in what's called soft altitude and is allowed to move up and down 50 feet to hold that level. And the scale shows 37,500 down to 36,500. If we set a different target altitude, which is partially obscured here, if Graham sets 330, which will be our next target altitude probably, it shows at the bottom. The box here indicates that we have the standard altimeter subscale setting of 1013 millibars.